One of Woodrow Wilson's many reforms, the Walsh Act, provided Jersey City with the machinery to change from a mayor-council form of government to the suddenly popular commission plan. It was supposedly superior to the mayor-council form because each commissioner was directly responsible to the people for the operation of his department.
The Catholic immigrants of New Jersey were looking for a man who would show them how to settle a half century of scores with the native Protestants who had abused and oppressed them. They wanted a leader who would march them into political battle. They found him here in Jersey City.
Frank Hague came out of the Horseshoe, that slum-ridden slice of downtown Jersey City, christened by the Republican gerrymander of 1871. Perhaps the least known and most remarkable part of his astonishing rise to ruler of New Jersey was his early image as a progressive reformer. Hague went all out for the city commission reform measure, calling it an ideal way to get rid of an incompetent mayor. His chief opponent in Hudson County, H. Otto Whitpen. The voters approved the change in government, and in 1913, the voters elected Hague as police commissioner. Hague launched an all-out assault on police laxity. Hague's cops began enforcing for the first time city laws against prostitution and after-hours drinking. Police Commissioner Hague had literally cleaned up the city.
In the municipal election of 1917, Hague ran a slate of five candidates, four Irish Catholics and one Protestant, and all five romped to victory. Hague was unanimously chosen mayor of Jersey City by the new commissioners.
Having purportedly banished boss rule, Hague now went to work on other progressive targets, the utilities and the railroads. In 1917 and 1918, he increased the tax assessments on the Standard Oil Company and on the Public Service Corporation, the holding company that dominated gas, electricity, and inner-city transportation in much of the state. Under Hague, Hudson replaced Essex as the dominant Democratic county. Hague proceeded to consolidate his position by handpicking the next three governors of New Jersey. Scores of jobs that had been elective were placed under the governor's appointive power. There were more than 80 different boards and commissions, plus judgeships and 14 court systems at Hague's disposal. In 1929, the bottom dropped out of Republican prosperity on Wall Street, and the gray, dismal years of the Great Depression settled on the United States. As the private sector of the economy shrank under the impact of Wall Street's collapse, Frank Hague was transformed from a politician on the run to a titan with steadily swelling power. The loss of local tax revenue forced him to trim his city and county payrolls. But the jobs and money that flowed from Washington, D.C. more than made up this deficit in the patronage on which the machine depended. Hague won elections because he voiced the resentment, the deprivations of Jerseyans who had been denied a full participation in America's opportunities because of their religion or ethnic origin.
He continued to win elections even after it became obvious he was corrupt, because he brought these people into the mainstream of New Jersey's political and economic life.